Cakewalk by BandLab is a free digital audio workstation for Windows with lots of professional features. Today we'll look at everything that can be done in Cakewalk for recording music, including some of its special plugins and tools that not all other digital audio workstations have. For more details on how to use Cakewalk, we have done a full tutorial series on the software that could be helpful. Before continuing with this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever new videos are released. I'm a big fan of Cakewalk as a free digital audio workstation since it's completely packed with features to do any type of recording, from electronic music to full band recordings. Let's go over what this software is able to do and look at some of the most interesting things that not everyone is aware of. Audio recording in Cakewalk is one of its main features. With this program, we can connect our audio interface and record as many channels as the audio interface has all at once on separate tracks. So if I'm recording a drum kit, I can have separate tracks for my overheads, a few mics on the toms, separate mics for the top and bottom of the snare, and the kick drum. With my Focusrite Scarlett 18i20 audio interface, Cakewalk will allow me to record 16 microphone inputs at the same time. After that, we can trim the clips, cut them up and rearrange them, or even take multiple takes of the recording and combine them to splice it up into one best performance. The audio recording features in Cakewalk allow us a lot of control over these tracks. After everything is recorded, we can use the included mixing controls. Starting with the mixer view, we can adjust the volume and panning of everything to get the balance right and position it in space. Then we can add plugins, which we can change our sound with compression, equalization, and more. Cakewalk has the included Sonidus plugins, but we can also add our own VST plugins to the software through the settings, so it adds some customization to the software. Some of the plugins that are included are delay, compression, multiband compression, noise gating, equalization, wah-wah, phaser, modulation, reverb, and surround. Cakewalk has another way to add effects and mix the audio through the Pro Channel. The Pro Channel has more effects used to color the sound. We have console plugins used to emulate console hardware, equalization, compression, driver, and more through the Pro Channel. The effects can be subtle, but they can add warmth and color to the final song if we use it on every track. Moving on from audio, Cakewalk also has a lot of features for MIDI and electronic music production. MIDI allows us to record an instrument as events on the piano roll that have time, velocity, and note values, so it's not actually sound until it runs through an instrument plugin. MIDI can be added in Cakewalk through the piano roll manually by drawing in all the notes at the right time. The piano roll is also used to edit MIDI clips that are recorded from a MIDI keyboard. Cakewalk supports MIDI keyboards that are connected over USB or through MIDI cables connected to a USB audio interface. Using a MIDI keyboard lets us record the MIDI events a lot faster than with a piano roll. For MIDI, I'm using the Akai MPK249 USB MIDI keyboard with 49 keys, 16 drum pads, and automation controls. Since MIDI only sends signals to an instrument to make sound, we have to have some of these instruments installed to produce any sound with MIDI in Cakewalk. There is an included set of high-quality instruments called the Studio Instruments plugins that can be installed with Cakewalk. This gives us drums, bass, strings, and keyboard with a lot of different presets to change the sound and knobs to tweak them more from there. After that, we can also mix the instrument track with plugins in the same way we did for audio. There's also the Cakewalk TTS-1 synthesizer, but I don't use that too much because the instruments sound very electronic and there are better options available. We can also install our own VST instrument plugins from different developers to work with Cakewalk by BandLab. I have some plugins that were included with my MIDI controllers that I use, as well as some synthesizers from Traction. There's also a lot of free instrument plugins available online that can be downloaded and installed, and we've done videos on some of the best free instruments available. Like most digital audio workstations, Cakewalk also allows us to use automation on all the tracks. Automation lets us write changes in volume, panning, and plugin controls to a track that are then read and played back whenever the track plays. So this allows us to do things like set the volume level different for one section of the song, like turning it up or down. We can also change a plugin control for a section or pan the track left or right for a section of the song. All these automation controls can be drawn on the track, written by playing the track and changing the knobs, or added with the automation controls like faders and knobs on a MIDI controller. After everything is recorded, MIDI is tracked, the song is mixed, and the automation is applied, you can export the song as a variety of file types to save or share. Now let's get into some of the more interesting features of Cakewalk by BandLab, starting with the Overloud TH3 plugin. This is kind of a demo plugin that's included, but has many options and presets to get started with. Overloud TH3 is a guitar amp simulator plugin. That means that it can take a guitar signal that we record by plugging the guitar directly into the audio interface and process it to sound like it were running through a guitar amp. There's different combinations of amps, speaker cabinets, microphones, and even guitar effects pedals that are included. One of the cool things this allows us to do is use Cakewalk to practice electric guitar through our headphones without having to use an amp. We can apply the plugin to the track, turn on input monitoring, and listen as the guitar amp processing is applied in real time. Another tool we have in Cakewalk by BandLab is a free auto-tune demo plugin called Melodyne Essential. We can use this for basic pitch correction or even changing the pitch. Melodyne is also used to convert some audio clips to MIDI, but we did a separate video on that and the results were not that great. There are also free auto-tune plugins like G-Snap that can be added as VST plugins, and those even have the option to use MIDI input from another track to determine what pitch to snap to for the auto-tune. The last tool we can use in Cakewalk by BandLab is drum replacement. If we record a drum kit with separate microphones on the snare and kick, we can use the drum replacement to track whenever there's a kick or snare hit, then swap out that audio for samples. This can be used if we don't have great recordings to reinforce the sound, or if we don't have a very nice sounding kit. With this, we can add individual hits that are missed, remove hits, and really dial in the drum replacement tool so it captures all the snare or kick hits. We can completely replace them or blend them together. One last thing this can do is allow us to drag the audio clip onto a MIDI track. Then we can take all the events that the drum replacement program has captured and turn them into MIDI events. This lets us take our drum recording and play it through a virtual instrument plugin like the Studio Instruments Drums plugin instead, but we can only really do this with the isolated drums like kick, snare, and toms. Thanks for checking out this video on Cakewalk by BandLab. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for products featured in this video and social media links.